As children, we always hope studying to be less boring and a lot smarter. Well, today, I'm diving headfirst into ChatGPT's brand new study mode. Using my actual questions from class. From the year... Never mind. Will it just hand me instant answers or actually help me learn step by step? Let's jump in and see. Study Mode launched in July 2025 and is now built into both the free and paid versions of ChatGPT on mobile and desktop. Whenever you tap Study and Learn, ChatGPT stops giving quick answers and actually acts like a tutor, breaking problems down, quizzing you, and helping you learn step by step. You can also try these questions, upload PDFs or handwritten notes, speak your questions, and get help in multiple Indian languages. It's seriously that flexible. Okay, I've logged in. Go to Tools, Study and Learn. And yes, it gives you three options. Help me with my homework, explain a topic to me, create, it starts to help me with my homework. What subject, specific problem? Okay, let's give it a maths problem. Maths problem, solve this equation for me. Square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. See, okay, it's told me that it's a quadratic equation and we'll solve it step by step. Can you think of two numbers that multiply to give 6 and add to give minus 5? Okay, so it's not giving me direct answer. It's asking me which two numbers will give you 6 and add to give you minus 5. It's minus 3 and minus 2. Now it has told me, okay, nice try, really close. Minus 3 minus 2 gives you 6. Minus 3 plus minus 2 gives you 5. So your numbers are minus 2 and minus 3. Now use those numbers. Now again, it's asking me to factor the quadratic. That is, just fill in the blanks with those numbers. So x minus minus 3 and minus 2. Okay, so it is x minus 2 and x minus 3 equal to 0. Now, how do we solve it? Okay, what values of x make the equation true? Okay, so x is equal to 2 and x is equal to 3 will make it true. Correct. Okay, after solving, it has again asked me, can you explain me briefly how you solved it? So it's asking me which processes did I use. First, so let's just start what we just did. First, we found out which two numbers gave minus 6 as product and minus 5 as sum, and then fill those values in the variable x by using zero factoring method. Let's see, x minus 3 and x minus 2 is 0 or not. Okay, it's giving me a polished version also of it. First, we found two numbers, then we used to factor the equation using the zero product method. I said zero factoring, but it corrected me that I'm actually using a zero product method. Now I can go ahead and ask as well, what is zero product? Okay, now let's try a science question. We'll ask it a bit differently as well. So explain photosynthesis and quiz me as you explain. Okay, trying to be funny. Just tell me where it happens or what, then we'll build from there. Okay, plants. Photosynthesis happens in plants. Now it's explaining me what is photosynthesis. Okay, and has asked me, can you name two things that plants need to do photosynthesis? Sunlight, water. Correct. Just one more to complete the trio. What else do plants take in? It's the gas, so it's, and it starts with C, so it's also helping me as we go through. It's carbon dioxide. Now what do these plants make? These produce a type of sugar as gas they release. So it's giving me certain hints that where I should actually think, in which direction should I actually think in. Okay, let's just finish this early. Do you know this? It's glucose and oxygen. Sum it up in a sentence. Okay, so photosynthesis is the process where plants use sunlight, water, and carbon dioxide to make glucose and release oxygen. Can you say that back to me in your own word? Okay, photosynthesis is a process that plants use to produce glucose and oxygen. They use sunlight, water, and carbon dioxide for it. So as you can see, it's not just giving me an answer and ends the conversation there. It is also helping me revise what I've actually understood. You can continue with this quiz. It will deepen your knowledge in this particular subject, which is photosynthesis. We'll keep asking you questions and also help you revise as we go. Okay, so now let's ask it something related to history. Quiz me on World War II events and correct me. Correct me as we go along. Okay, so first thing is, what event marked the official start? This I know, it's B. Yes, so the answer was correct. Hitler invading Poland on September 1 started World War II. Okay, next question is, which countries made up the Axis power? I think it's Germany, USA and Soviet Union. Okay, my answer wasn't correct, so it has also corrected me that USA and Soviet Union were not part of the Axis power, but they were actually a part of allies. That's nice. And the actual answer was Germany, Italy and Japan. Okay, let's try one more. Which major event caused the USA to enter the war? I think it is D-Day. I'm clearly not sure. Okay, it's bombing of Pearl Harbor, and this is when it happened. Okay, I think let's try now, since I've got two answers wrong. Am I doing well in this quiz? So despite giving incorrect answers, it continues to encourage me. So that's a sign of a very good tutor. Okay, you can continue or let's switch to something else now. Okay, now let's try something else. Help me write a blog on ChatGPT study mode. I have already written two lines. Okay, let me copy paste my lines. Okay. How well, so it sounds natural, how well we'll do it. Intro, why it matters, what all it does. You've already got a good opening. And it has updated my intro for grammatical errors. And want to keep it friendly? Think of it like a teacher who guides you with questions instead of just try with your own version. Now it's asking me whether I want to keep it friendly and blog-like, or I want to make it professional. So you, as per your tone, you can also construct your blog. I'll just keep it friendly. Let's reply to it. Okay, think of it like your home tutor available 24/7. Correct. Okay, so as you can see, it's not giving me details of ChatGPT study mode. It's asking me in my own way how I can explain what I've understood. Now let me give some incorrect facts about ChatGPT study mode and let's see. ChatGPT study mode is like googling stuff without learning. But yes, see, since I gave a completely opposite idea, it has also told me that maybe what I have typed is actually factually incorrect. So it has helped me understand what exactly it is. Googling is actually helping without helping you learn, and study mode slows down and teaches you step by step. So it has suggested me the correct version as well. Like using normal search gives you quick answers but no real understanding. But ChatGPT study mode changes that. It teaches you how to think and not just what to write. So it is not just blindly accepting my suggestions as well, it is correcting me as we go through. Okay, now let's just ask it for the complete blog. Give me the complete blog that I have written so far. Okay, see, it's given me a nice title which I had not earlier provided. Whatever suggestions I have given, like 24/7, this is my starting line. And this is as well that it corrected my factual understanding. So yeah, that's how ChatGPT study mode works.
There isn't official data yet for study mode adoption, but education is consistently among ChatGPT's top users worldwide. Trusted surveys show about 1 in 3 university students already use generative AI tools for learning support. Over 7,000 academic misconduct cases tied to AI use were reported in UK universities just last year, proving how big AI's role in education has become. Study mode is more than just a cheat button. It's designed to help you actually understand and remember, not just get through your homework. My verdict, it won't replace a real teacher, but if you want to learn independently, it's surprisingly helpful and actually fun to use. What would you try first in study mode? Drop your hardest question in the comments. Want more real-world AI tests like this? Smash that like, hit subscribe, and I'll keep reviewing the newest features.